afternoon. Thanks to all, to IPG India, to the MIT University for organizing this symposium, to all of you. My presentation is focused on the IPG and its numerous activities to develop and promote geoethics worldwide. What is the IPG? The International Association for Promoting Geoethics is a multidisciplinary platform for widening the discussion and creating awareness about the values and problems of ethics applied to the geosciences. And through these slides, I want to give you some essential information about the IPG. The IPG was founded in 2012 during the 35th IGC in Brisbane. It's a scientific, non-governmental, non-political association, legally registered as a not-for-profit organization. It is officially hosted at the Italian Institute of Geophysics and Volcanology in Rome. And our network can count on more than 2,550 members in 129 countries on five continents. And here you see the bodies of the association, that are the Executive Council, the General Assembly, that is held every 4 years during the IGC, the Board of Experts, the delegates, the Early Career Scientist Teams, that is recently have been renewed, and 31 national sections and task groups working on some relevant issues such as responsible mining and geoethics in forensic geology. And in any case, details about our organizations can be read on the IPG website. The IPG cooperates with various international organizations with which shares some values and whose objectives are complementary to the IPG goals. Cooperation takes place through different forms. We have seven affiliations, 20 agreements for cooperation, and five partnerships. In the picture you see our Secretary General Silvia Peppoloni, who signed an agreement for cooperation with the International Association of Geomorphologists last year in Vienna. The IPG strategy, this is the scheme of the IPG strategies for promoting geoethics in the period 2019-2022. And our goals are to develop and organize publications, projects, conferences, activities involving society. And in red you can see the two new great initiatives that we have launched in 2019, a school on geoethics and a new series on geoethics by the publisher Springer Nature. And I will give you details about in the next slides. First of all, I would give you some information about projects. The IPG is currently involved at various levels in international projects. It is partner of the European Project GOAL. GOAL means geoethics outcomes and awareness learning. And IPG has cooperated to develop a geoethical syllabus, an e-book, and other educational resources such as videos on geoethics to be used in higher education programs. The IPG has been included also in the International Advisory Board of the European Project Intermin, focus on the International Network of Raw Materials Training Centers. And in the recent past, the IPG cooperated also with the European Project Embry Plus to develop the ethical guidelines for the European environmental and Earth System research infrastructures. And it is important for me to underline that the IPG doesn't receive money from these projects. In 2019, IPG started to work on an internal project. This is our first internal project aimed at running an international survey on geoethics through an online questionnaire. And I will give you more details later in the presentation. Some words about the School on Geoethics and Natural Issues. It was founded on July 2019. the school aims to provide excellent education in geoethics. At the moment, the school is a virtual place providing online resources. You can find a lot of resources in the, our website. We have planned two short courses, respectively, at the IGC in Delhi last March and at the ADU in Vienna last May, but we were forced to delay both of them due to the pandemic. But we have several plans for the future, so please stay tuned. We have ideas to develop new projects in the recent future. The school provides several videos and interviews on different subjects of interest for geoethics, with the aim of triggering and disseminating the discussion on geoethical issues. You find these videos in our website or in the IPG YouTube channel. As I said before, in 2019, another important initiative was carried out. Our Secretary General Silvia Pepoloni was invited by Springer Nature to create a Springer Briefs in geoethics. In the slide, you can see the members of the editorial board, and we have published the first book of the series entitled Relationships and the Course of Social Events During Mineral Exploration and Applied Sociology Approach by Ian Boone, who is our coordinator of IPG Canada. And our and new books will be proposed soon. The IPG has always had publications among its core activities, fundamental, starting from the first volume in 2012 till the last book published in 2019 by Palgrave Pivot with the title Exploring Geoethics. This book, Exploring Geoethics, frames geoethics from a philosophical and theoretical way. It addresses current debates on geoethics, approaches geoethics from an interdisciplinary perspective, and discusses the practical applications of geoethics. Now we are working for publishing another book in the Lyell Collection of the Geological Society of London, entitled Geoethics, Status and Future Perspectives. All chapters of this new book have been submitted, many have been already accepted, and others are at the review stage. But we count on to publish this book till the end of the year. IPG members have also published numerous articles on geoethics in international journals under a peer review process. This is another important aspect. So papers are available on the IPG website, and most of them are for free download. So please, I invite you always to visit our website. You find a lot of resources on geoethics. Another important activity of the IPG is to organize scientific sessions on geoethics within the most important geoscience congresses. We organize sessions at the EGU General Assembly every year from 2012. The EGU is the most important geoscience congress in Europe and one of the most important in the world. We have planned to organize an entire symposium on geoethics at the IGC in Delhi. And as you know, probably the IGC was postponed. And we have also organized other events at the EGU meeting, EGU fall meeting. These are only some examples. We have organized a lot of sessions also in other important congresses like RFG, the Ocean Science Meetings, or in Morocco, for example. Due to the COVID, we moved from physical to virtual some events. For example, the International Congress on Geoethics and Groundwater Management that was held in May as a joint event between IPG and the International Association of Hydrogeologists. Other initiatives of the IPG. IPG Peru organized Miner Lima, an international exhibition to promote geosciences and geoethics among Peruvian people from 2015. So this year we will hold the sixth edition, and numerous activities are in preparation during this event. From 2017, IPG Peru organized also every year the roundtable on geoethics in Lima. IBG Brazil is responsible for the module on geoethics within the training course on ocean governments, marine sciences and geoethics that is organized by the International Ocean Institutes. And this symposium of this day is another important step. I think that we have a lot of participants, and this is really important. It's a great event, probably the most important event that we have on geoethics with a wider audience. From 2017, the IPG has launched the International Geoethics Day. This year we will celebrate the fourth edition, and probably the annual motto will be Make a Geoethical Promise. The aim of the International Geoethics Day is to raise the awareness of the science community and society as a whole about the importance of ethical, social and cultural aspects of geoscience knowledge, research, practice, education and communication is a way also to promote geoethics within society. The Geoethics Medal from 2018, IPG awards geoscientists with the Geoethics Medal. This medal goes to geoscientists who have distinguished themselves in applying, favoring, assuring ethical approaches in the geoscience research and practice. Candidatures can be still submitted for the 2020 edition, and more information are also available on the IPG website. In the past two editions, we awarded the Geoethics Medal to Chris King for his great work on geoeducation, and to Linda Gunderson for leading the advancement in scientific integrity and professional ethics in the geosciences. Finally, as I anticipated, in 2020, we have launched the online questionnaire for an international survey on geoethics. The survey aims at investigating the geoscience community's perception about the importance of the ethical and social aspects in the geosciences. Compilers can decide to fill in the questionnaire anonymously. The survey has been partially funded by the IUGS through the annual fund allocation to the IPG, and you are all invited to fill in the questionnaire and to share the link with your colleagues. So thank you if you help us in running this international survey. I have just presented some of the activities of the IPG, probably the most important, but we have a lot of other activities. You can find detailed information on our website. You will discover that IPG is much more than an organization. This is a focal point for me. It's a global project for contributing to change ways in which human beings interact with the Earth system. This is our duty for current and future generations. I invite you, all of you, to become IPG members. There is no fee to pay. You find the link in our website. There is an online form to fill in. And thank you for your attention.